developers work and minimize cost and error to optimize their business.
We at Logic Distribution provide integrated platform for managing business process, which occur between principal and market, to bring an end-to-end supply chain ecosystem from rural to urban infrastructure. We collaborate with many parties in connecting sub-ecosystem to serve for the goods of people, small merchants, salesperson, warehouse owners, distributor, and principals. We try to simplify the complexity of the whole distribution process using our digital solution and capability to break the current silo ecosystem.
In the logistics and supply chain industry, often involves many parties, be it units within the company, partners, customers, and oftentimes using multiple and diverse platform and application. At Logic Control Tower, we handle supply chain data processing, surfing, giving alerts and recommendation all in one single platform. So the whole picture of end-to-end logistic process is visible to all, helping companies and parties improve to see and get better insight to improve their business and operations.
Life at Logic. Building a great product will be impossible without a group of wonderful people working behind it. We are proud to say that we have a great team who is customer obsessed, understand the value of focus, and acknowledge that the product is always evolving. Here at Logic, we care deeply for all our team members by creating a healthy environment and positive space for everyone to work and play. We believe happy and engaged individuals makes more productive, creative, and innovative teams. That's the result of great products of Logic.
Hari ini, dunia terus bergerak, berevolusi dengan cepat. Sadar atau tidak, kita telah dikelilingi oleh pesatnya inovasi teknologi digital yang seakan baru terjadi kemarin. Dunia terus berlomba melahirkan inovasi dalam segala bidang. Apakah kita hanya berdiam diri menjadi saksi dan menerima keadaan? Kita harus melakukan lompatan, bukan sekedar mengejar angan-angan. Bergerak cepat dengan seluruh kekuatan. Telkom Indonesia mempersembahkan Lead, motor penggerak yang akan mengambil posisi terdepan dalam menciptakan lompatan dengan mendorong inovasi teknologi digital melalui pengembangan, kolaborasi, dan inkubasi untuk melahirkan ekosistem digital. Inilah usaha kami dalam mencari solusi dan memberi dampak yang positif bagi kehidupan rakyat Indonesia, sehingga kita makin berdaya dan dipandang dunia. Saatnya anak negeri take a leap untuk kedaulatan digital Indonesia.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming to the Indonesia Pavilion at Expo 2020 Dubai. Ladies and gentlemen, our program for today is Business Talk held by Telkom Indonesia with the topic of today is Telkom Digital from Silo Logistic to Ecosystem Platform, Simplify Digital Connecting Ecosystem. We are live from Expo 2020 Dubai at Indonesia Pavilion, and this business talk also live on Instagram and YouTube Telkom Indonesia. It is the great honor for me to welcome everybody here to join us, and we are going to have great speakers to share knowledge and news and also experience and expertise. And the great speakers this morning are keynote speaker from Executive Vice President Digital Business Technology Telkom Indonesia, Mr. Saiful Hidayat. Head of Logistic Ecosystem Telkom Indonesia, Mr. Natal Iman Ginting. Vice President Wholesale Payment Bank Mandiri, Mr. Norman Defrizal. Chairman of Asosiasi Pengusaha Truk Indonesia, Aptrindo, Mr. Gemilang Tarigan. And also, the President Director of New Priuk Container Terminal 1, NPCT1, Mr. Takao Omori. To start, we would like to welcome our moderator this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, big applause for Mr. Kunchoro Wastu Wibowo, Synergy Project Leader, MSME, Logistic and SOE, Telkom Indonesia. Mr. Kunchoro, the floor is yours.
Yes. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning and good afternoon to you all, dear speakers and audience. Welcome to the Business Talk at the Indonesia Pavilion Dubai Expo 2020 with an exciting topics, Telkom Digital from Silos to Ecosystem Platform, Simplifying Digitally Connected Logistic Ecosystem. I'm your moderator today. My name is Kunchoro, or you can call me Kun. We'll present today five excellent speeches carried out by five inspiring speakers and followed by a Q&A session where the audience may ask questions. But first, I will introduce the speaker to you now. The first speaker is Mr. Saiful Hidayat, the Executive Vice President of Digital Business and Technology, Telkom Indonesia. With current responsibilities and 30 years experience with Telkom Group, Saiful committed to pursue the company vision as it transformed to be a digital telecommunication company and bring the team to be leaner and more agile in adapting and fast-changing nature for the digital transformation. Previously, Saiful was the Vice President of Integrated Portfolio Management and is currently taking his doctorate degree at Brawijaya University in the field of strategic management. Saiful encourages everyone to take a leap, develop, innovate, and grow faster with Telkom Indonesia to establish a digital sovereignty in Indonesia. The second speaker is Natal Iman Ginting, the Head of Vertical Digital Logistic Ecosystem, Telkom Indonesia. Natal is responsible in architecting the logistic digital platform as a new digital portfolio, including the logistic solution, business and operation model, and the way to bring it to the market. Natal holds an MBA from University of Birmingham, or we should call it Birmingham, in the UK, and a certification of corporate governance from National University Singapore. His main emphasis is how to implement digital transformation in developing new capabilities in the area of e-trade, e-commerce, and e-logistics. The next speaker is Norman Defrizal, the Vice President Wholesale Payment at Bank Mandiri. Norman is a well-rounded global transaction banker with more than 25 years of experience, demonstrating his ability to lead a variety of transactional banking professionals in the sector. He has a strong technical and business qualification of strategic planning, business development, and risk management. His specialties are cash management, trade finance, supply chain finance, international banking, and correspondent banking. Norman is also certified for professional trainer of transaction banking and risk management level 4. The next excellent speaker is Gemilang Tarigan, the chairman of Aprindo, the Indonesian Truck Entrepreneur Association. Gemilang holds a degree in the MBA program in international business, CSPU California, and also certified for customer expert total quality management training in Tokyo and lead assessor on ISO 9000. Gemilang is also the chairman of the Committee for Coordinating of Association for Transportation, Tourism, Post, Mass Media, Communication Technology, and Information Services. And the last, but also the most curious speaker is Takao Omori, President Director of New Priok Container and Terminal 1 or NPCT 1. Having more than 35 years of experience in logistic industry, Takao-san is highly skilled in logistic infrastructure, digital transformation, supply chain optimization, also in automation and robotics. He has more than 10 logistic infrastructure projects, including container, air cargo, and transloading terminal. In such digital area, Takao also leads the company's digital transformation for its business future with an innovative and digitally led business model. So those are the speakers for our session today. We'll have each speaker enlighten us briefly for 15 minutes, sharp. I'm now asking Mr. Saiful Hidayat for our first enlightenment. Please, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Mr. Saiful for the first 15 minutes. Please, Pak Saiful.
Okay, thank you, Mas Kuncoro. Thank you, Mas Kuncoro. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning and good afternoon, distinguished guests and participants. As asked by moderator, just wanted to share, and then will be more deep detail on with the next speaker is about how is the logistic industry in Indonesia, and also what are the role for digitalization in logistic to optimizing this industry in Indonesia, and also what has been done by Telkom Indonesia in this logistic industry, and also maybe in the last, I wanted to share and also to encourage partner or other investor to joining with us to make bigger the industry of logistic in Indonesia. Okay, next. Just as mentioned by MC and the moderator, just wanted to share how we can make from silo logistic ecosystem in Indonesia to become in the one platform. As you know, the Indonesia logistic market size is quite lucrative. You can see on this chart on 2020, the market size is just already to 275 billion rupiah USD. And also with the revenue CAGR more than 7.9% for each year. This is a good opportunity for us for creating digitalization in industry logistic market. Next. And if you see how this logistic growth opportunity in Indonesia is because of five things that influence it. First is about the rising the middle class is make boosting the disposable income. And also, as you know, between this 5 years, including, of course, we don't expect it and we don't want it, but the lesson learned or the good thing about this COVID pandemic is everything become digital, including the rise of the e-commerce in Indonesia, which is more than 80% CAGR. It's also is rising the need for logistics. Because you know when it's come the flow of the information will be also followed by the flow of good. And also now Indonesia becoming the fourth largest internet user globally. Almost 65% people in Indonesia is already using internet, especially using the mobile internet. And also in logistic services itself, we can see that it's already achieved double digit grow. So again, this is a very lucrative and very attractive market that we can do it together here. Before I'm continuing about what is the Telkom Indonesia has been done to this logistic industry, including the opportunity to work together, just wanted to share a bit about the Telkom Indonesia. First, we are the state-owned enterprises. Mostly we owned by the government of Indonesia, 42%, and then the rest is on the public through stock exchange, not only in Indonesia stock exchange, but also in New York stock exchange, we listed there. We have 10 sub-holding and more than 30 subsidiary in total. Next. We has and we become the biggest telco operator in Indonesia because in consumer on the line, we has more than 8 million fixed subscriber and also more than 9 million fixed line. And then in the mobile, we also the biggest. We have almost 170 million subscriber, and also for mobile subscriber is almost 180 million subscriber. So you can see here the opportunity that we can reach and we can improve the logistic industry to digitalization, because also we has the base customer that's very huge here. And also next, in terms of infrastructures, we are ready to support to improve the logistic infrastructure, because as you know that we are having almost 4 times around the world in the Indonesia digital network. Our fiber optic is almost 4 times in the world. And also we are having the most BTS for mobile, is more than 35,000 BTS, including supporting by hyperscale data center and also 25 data center that located around Indonesia. And also we have all the digital platform, including cloud, including security, big data, IoT, and et cetera. Okay, next. So as the national program from our president, that one of the national agenda is to improve and to increase the logistic industry. So Telkom Indonesia, following that instruction, also providing not only the horizontal platform that I can also can use by other vertical ecosystem, especially we also focusing on this logistic ecosystem to support and to make how can we improve the logistic ecosystem to optimize, to reduce the cost, and especially to improve the economic of the Indonesia. Following that instruction from our president, next. In Telkom digital ecosystem, we also focusing on digital service on logistic. We call it Logi. Yeah, of course, as I already shared before, we have the digital connectivity because we are the biggest operator in Indonesia for the connectivity, fixed connectivity or mobile connectivity. And also, as I mentioned before, we also providing the platform, including the payment, the big data, IoT, cloud, and et cetera. And also for digital service, we are one of the focus of the industry is in the logistics. This also supporting and following the national agenda that has been instructed by our president. Okay, next. So as we are doing the digital initiative in Telkom Indonesia, we has been recently launched the umbrella brand. We call it LIP because we wanted the ecosystem. We wanted that everybody joining together with us to improve the digital ecosystem, especially now we are talking about the logistic digital ecosystem to become LIP. LIP mean you are just like not incremental improvement, but you are leaping. You have become more better, more wellness, and et cetera. So with this umbrella brand, we are focusing on 3 area. First, we are trying to also to provide and improve the digital talent, because as facing by the growth of need in digitalization in Indonesia, the quality of digital talent in Indonesia is good, but the challenge is in terms of number. Now we are facing short shortage of the number on digital talent. That's why we are encouraging, we try to nurturing the digital talent in Indonesia, so we can also provide the best digital talent that can be improve the digital ecosystem in Indonesia. And also we are working together, we are encouraging many people to become the digital leader, not only in Telkom and also in outside of Telkom. And also we are, what do you call it? We are encourage our team to become entrepreneur. One of their idea, we are incubate and becoming a product, including this Logi. It started from the initiative that internally from our team, and then we are incubate, and then we are try to accelerate, and now becoming one of our main vertical solution. And of course, this result is on the digital product that we are trying not just selling the product, but we wanted to creating the ecosystem, because we believe the ecosystem play more important role compared to just one or two vertical product. Next. After this, maybe my colleague Pak Nantal will more detail explaining about what is the Logi as part as our initiative to improve the logistic industry in Indonesia. It consists three, consists three solution as part of the ecosystem. The first is about the Logi transformation, the Logi transportation that's try to bring the ecosystem of cargo owner that meet with the logistic fleet owner in one digital ecosystem. As we know, the problem in logistics sometimes, the fleet owner, why the cost of logistics is higher? Because the charging is in two way backs. Sometimes they try to bring the goods, especially from West Indonesia to East Indonesia. And then when the fleet come back, it's empty. That's why the cost is expensive. They are difficult to find cargo owner that need to bring back from the east to the west. So this platform help them to mix together between the fleet owner and the cargo owner. So hoping this will reduce the cost. No more fleet empty when coming back after dropping to a certain area. And then the other is Logi Distri. We try to cut the distribution channel of good. It means we will increase the profit of principal, sales, and outlet. And last is about the Logi control, is optimizing tracking your logistic. We know on each pace of the transportation. This Logi control, we use it very successfully on the distribution of vaccine. So we knowing where is the vaccine, starting from the biopharma until in the, we call it puskesmas. We know every node and every time this vaccine being distributed. This is the three of our solution in Logi, and our principle, we try to be open. We open to all kind of players to join on the ecosystem. We not discriminated. We also already joining in this ecosystem the banking, because we know everything will be about also the payment. With natural, we not compete with the user, because we are not the logistic company. We are the ICT company. We try to digitalize the logistics, so we not compete with the user with joining this ecosystem. Also, of course, as one of the main needed, this platform is secure and also intelligent, because everything you need the information you will get from this platform, and my colleagues will explain more detail after this. And last but not least, we are inviting, next please, to all the distinguished participants and guests together to collaborate to strengthen the logistic ecosystem, especially in Indonesia. There are many areas that we can work together, such as in area of business process consulting, on managed service and joint operation, and also still open to logistic solution provider, or also how we can expand to the global market with joining with the other logistic global provider, including maybe with other digital logistic provider in other country. Because as you know, we still also need to work together when we try to export our good, especially from the UMKM to other country. And also about the custom logistic solution, because as we know, we also need about the exit permit, the custom exercise. So this one part also area that can be collaborate. And the most important is about the talent. We also open for the partner to work together with us to improve on the train and the capability of the talent, not only on the digital talent itself, but also in the business process of logistics. Because a digital is just a tool, but again, it's about how we can define a process and a system that very effectively and very efficiently, and that can be made and have the logistic solution in Indonesia become very good, very cheap, and can be compete with other country. So these are the area that can be works together. Ladies and gentlemen, we are inviting, we can work together on the people side, like joint business ecosystem or with the academy technology, or to do supply chain training, and also in the process, just I mentioned before, or we can improve the business process. Maybe in the other countries, such as in Dubai, I heard that in Dubai is the logistic is very short and very fast. Maybe we can work together. How can that be implemented in Indonesia? And of course, the area of this technology. So that can be what can I share to you, distinguished participants and guests. And maybe we can discuss more detail on the next presenter or on the Q&A. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Mr. Sefu, for your sharp insight. As his name implies, actually, Pak Saiful's name, Saif, means sword, and we have just seen a very sharp insight indeed. Many thanks. Now, for the second speech, we invite Mr. Natal Ginting to energize us in digital logistic transformation. Please, Mr. Ginting, Pak Natal, energize us over the next 15 minutes.
Thank you very much, Pak Kun. Is my slide already displayed, Pak? Ya?
Yes, it's clear.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon from Jakarta. I'm very pleased to be joined in this very good event. My name is Natal Iman Ginting. As said by Pak Saiful, I look after the Logi. Logi is a logistic ecosystem digital platform, one of the strategic and important initiative in the telecom. Since beginning, Logi is designed to attack two key problems in the logistic Indonesia. The first one is how we can provide digital solution to the player in Indonesia, logistic player and cargo owner, so they can embrace the transformation of the digital. That is first. And the second is we also are facilitating them connecting to their ecosystem, because we believe in logistic, without optimizing the ecosystem, we cannot optimize the supply chain itself. So there is logic. But let's start a little bit after a long time in this logistic. We noticed that logistic, you know, globally everywhere is transformed right now. The most important thing factor is because all transaction, either B2B or B2C, is going to online. What does it mean? Surfing online demand is very different with the legacy logistic. It increased the cost of the 30% for the current principle of cargo owner surfing in this new area. Not only increasing the cost, but it also increasing the chance to turn red. Yeah? Because if your product not available in the outlet, right now, 50% chance it will be turned, your customer. So it's mean that in the current era, all parties, cargo owner and logistic partner, must adjust themselves for this situation. And also don't forget that this logistic, at least for every retailer, need at least 10 plus parties, yeah, to coordinate. So we can imagine how important optimizing this ecosystem will be in this area. That is in the global. If we can see in Indonesia, more specifically, most of the logistic player here in Indonesia in the very early stages of the digitalization. And also number two, which is very important to notice, that for the very big country like Indonesia, we notice that we have no giant or very big logistic player in Indonesia. And that is why if we see the numbers in the world, that 24% of our GDP, it is very big. 24% of our GDP is a logistic cost. Compared to the other country, the number should be less than 15%. So we cannot make this country efficient or competitive without making the logistic is competitive. So this is a very real challenge, yeah, for our country, for the sector. So that is why the government actually already announced to attacking this problem, trying to make it down less than 20 in the next 3 to 4 years. So that is some background for us to understand how big the challenge the sector facing right now here in Indonesia. And before we going into the logi itself, take a look of the logistic itself. I'm very happy today. My partner, long time partner Pak Gemilang from Truk, and also Pak Omori from the port, and Pak Norman join to us. It's very relevant. If we see here, trucking, for example, we are talking about trucking specifically here. Trucking in Indonesia is huge business. Yeah, 90% of the transportation of the logistic will be doing by truck. The trucking business is very huge, about 450 trillion a year. I can say, and Pak Gemilang, I think, will elaborate later with Putut, without efficient trucking system, we cannot make the logistic also efficient. Because trucking is also unique. It is a kind of linkage between first mile into the last mile. So if we cannot make this trucking business efficient, it will be help much. Yeah. Please note that sometimes this number is quite different a little bit, because in Indonesia, when we call it 20% of our GDP is in the logistic, but most of this logistic built by in-house logistic. So big cargo owner in Indonesia like PLN, Pertamina, and all mining, they doing their own logistic. Why? Because when they outsourcing the logistic to the outside, there is not more giant logistic to taking lead over. So that is the challenge. And that is we are going to discuss a little bit more about this trucking, and also how it connect to its ecosystem with Logi. By understanding this, we in Telkom and in Logi aiming to make a national logistic digital platform that bridging producer and the outlet for better logistic. What is for better logistic mean? Better logistic mean that we can share capacity logistic, either it is transporter or warehousing or the last mile delivery. We can connecting it to the ecosystem and also even to the global. We can manage end-to-end visibility, optimize process through intelligent process. So, but this end state, we cannot achieve that end state without digitization first. So that is why, as Pak Saibul already mentioned, we are trying to facilitating first, simplify this logistic by provide solution for the transporter, for the distributor, and also for the logistic player through these three pillar: Logitrans, Logi Distribution, Logi Control Tower. We are doing this in this last near 2 years, and we are quite happy right now. There are near 37,000 fleet already enjoy end-to-end digital, paperless, integrated Logi, the tracker, enjoying by 50 and also 6,000 outlet B2B that already integrated from order to the fulfillment. We do it with the many our colleague from Step Out. However, it's also open for all small business and enterprise in Indonesia. Yes, of course, initially we are going to develop solution. We are going to develop platform. But whenever we do it, we always remember for each application of the logi, we always thinking about how we are going to beyond four wall, connecting it to its ecosystem. How we are going to digitally end to end, not only silo, but end to end. For example, in the trucking business, there are 9 process since cargo owner searching for the trucking until the trucking sending the invoice. There are 9 process. We aiming to digitalize it end to end. And also we always keep how to make it more automation, more intelligent. And the last, but very important is how we can integrate this movement of information and good with the financial. So that's why I'm happy also our colleague from Mandiri joined in this opportunity. So right now we have 8 sub-platforms in the logi. Number one is Logitrack, already mentioned. This is a marketplace for the tracking. We connecting it to the port. So that with the port is already connecting to proving that ecosystem is connected to our logi. And also we are in the process interconnecting it to the airport and also to the rail. That is in the transportation side. In the distribution side, we already making order universal order. So principal or cargo owner no need to doing by silo. They own order through their own outlet. We providing universal order. We providing universal sales management and also it is fulfillment. So if we see logi, 3 circle is a logistic player and cargo owner and this digital aggregator is logi. Is a team, yeah, to make end-to-end process is more efficient. That is what we aiming for. So this is one example how we are going to do that. For example, we already in the place in the outlet, either it is kiosk, warung, rural, bumdes, warung pupuk. We put a logi order so the outlet can order so many SKU that registered by principal. So principal no need to build their own order, and this order we are going to optimize it and we are going to fulfill it through our small depot and hub, and it is all transparent into the principal. So right now operation digital end to end by principal can see up to the warung. It can be better synchronized, yeah, between their marketing, production, and distribution model. This is what logi distribution already do in this distribution. And also in this distribution we can make a specific for example we have a community especially for the rural, because rural SKU is quite different, so we make it a sub platform for the rural, so it is also customized for it. So logi distribution is a friend, is a partner for the principal, is a partner for the kiosk. How together we make this universal order, universal fulfillment, and universal inventory more efficient. This is an example, as I mentioned, how we are doing it in Bandung. In the 5 months, yeah, we have already in one location, I just give you an example, 5,200 outlet, we already happy customer, yeah, we're serving. So this outlet and UMKM no need more to go back to the principal or to the grocer. They just simply order it, whatever product they need, and we are going to fulfill it. And for the principal, precisely know where they good goes. And this is in the distribution and the transportation. I already mentioned we have 3, and this is also already enjoyed by 37,000 truck enjoyed end-to-end digital digitization and connecting to their ecosystem, fully paperless, real-time tracking, and also we provide financing service. And this is an example for you how our solution in the Logitrack. And thank you, Pak Omori, the pioneer that enabled us to among the first, yeah, to connect to the port. So right now you do not need to go to the port to pay the port service. You do not need to go to port to print your get system. You can do it all integrated with the logi by coordination with the NPCT1. Also right now we are already did with the COJA and already in discussion with the GICT1. And this will be expand, yeah, further and further. So at least this ecosystem will be seamless and we can be orchestrated. So at the last, it's long way to go. But right now, if we see All legacy transportation system is just a wallet garden. Yeah, everybody look after their own business. They are starting to connect it, to automate it, yeah, but still that still in the world garden. What we need to do is just imagine, yeah, one day all of this truck, all of this warehousing will be a data collaborative, yeah, system centric. So it will be ecosystem driven and data driven ecosystem. So that is what Logi aim in the next 2 or 3 years. At last, Logi invite, yeah, all manufacturers, all trader, all logistic player, and also logistic startup, like bringing new logistic capabilities to the nation in this new era of e-commerce. Only by collaboration, by digital platform, we can bring Indonesia logistic supply chain competitive advantage in this new era. That is Logi presentation, and thank you very much.
Yeah, big appreciation for Mr. Natal. Pak Natal, it is a real encouragement for us all here that we have actually designed and start establishing the ecosystem logistic business in Indonesia. So thanks again. I would also like to remind the audience that we will have a 30-minute session for Q&A. So please don't forget to write your question on our chat room, and the committee will select the question for after that. The next speaker is Mr. Norman Devrizal, the Vice President of Wholesale Payment at Bank Mandiri. Mr. Norman will enrich our understanding on this logistic ecosystem with his long experience in financing world. So let's put our attention now to Mr. Norman. Please, Pak Norman.
Okay, thank you, Pak Kunchoro. Good afternoon, everyone. Good morning from somebody sitting in Dubai. So basically, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Norman Devrizal. I was in the banking industry more than 25 years. I know Pak Natal as my one of the colleague in digitalization of the SOE, and I saw from the sum of presentations basically to highlight on the, you know, the digitization of the logistic and transportation. But from my angle is basically I would like to highlight in terms of the banking capability to support the logistic and also the transportation for the Indonesia. Okay, let me start my presentation here. Okay, I saw some topic discussion today is going to be more on the digitization of logistic ecosystem in Indonesia, which I believe Telkom Indonesia has led this initiative for the past few years. We also, as a bank of and also the SOE banks, is also committed to provide a best-in-class financial solution to the wholesale banking during digitization for being number one customer experience, especially on the many ecosystem such as logistic and transportation. As the fact that the last year, BMRI or Bank Mandiri has launched two digital initiative, which is Kopra by Mandiri. This is actually for the wholesale customer. And the second is Livin by Mandiri. This is for the retail or individual customer. And I would like to highlight on the Kopra by Mandiri as digital super platform of Mandiri for the wholesale customer. If you see on the my slide, so this basically the Kopra is the new digital super platform that's launched since last year, which provides a comprehensive and end-to-end digital solution for customer and their business ecosystem to make transaction more efficient, streamlined, and seamless, and also to encourage closed-loop transaction, as well as to increase the product holding with the bank. Kopra basically has a three variants of solution for the customer. If you see on the left side, you can see the host. This is basically for the principal or the big customer who can direct integration connected to our system into their system. So the payment and collection, trade guarantee and supply chain can be done seamless and efficiently. And also we do have some Kopra portal, which is what we call is basically the web-based solution that to integrate the 6 portal in Mandiri. We've got Bank Mandiri cash management, financial supply chain management, Global Trade, Smart Account, EFX, and Mandiri Online Custody. This is basically the 6 portal we have today for our wholesale client card. And last is we have a partnership. This is basically the integration with the vendor to provide the solution for the retailers or non-bankable customer. I just want to highlight some point that highlighted by Pak Natal. So it's basically Logi also can help for the toko, the smaller store here. So basically the corporate partnership also can help the customer which has non-bankable customer. Okay, on the next slide, please. So if you see on the slide, so you can see that we've got the experience to handling the ecosystem by via Kopra by Mandiri. As you see on the port system, if you can the chart that we've got the different solution for each member ecosystem from port operator, the shipping line, custom and tax, consignee, forwarder, that all integrated and connected through Kopra by Mandiri. So it would help the member of ecosystem to transact, inquire, financial transaction more efficient, seamless, and then closed loop transaction. So this is the fact that we've got the experience to provide the tailored solution for the ecosystem, especially for the logistic. Next slide, please. In terms of the performance, you can see on the slide that for the last year, the term of the world of share by Mandiri in 2001, our turnover last year is around 35,500 trillion rupiah. It is basically in rupees, or 35 out of market share for the national digital bank transaction. So actually, we are the market leader to support the digitalization for the customer wholesale for the wholesale customer. If you see on the slide, also in terms of their volume, the bank guarantee itself has increased significantly more than 25%. On the trade side, also we got increased around 28%. In terms of the cash management, is increased significantly around 37%, and also on the FX, this is basically we increased around 28%. So basically, this is which I believe that can support the port ecosystem for the guarantee, for the trade, for cash, as well as for the treasury of the FX. On the next slide, you can see that Kopra just launched in last year, but we are not stopped here. We still have so many features to come and then near future. So basically, we still continue to develop the new features, new initiative to support the customer ecosystem, not only to the transportation or logistic. We are also have some kind of experience to build on the airport ecosystem or the FMCG ecosystem, which I believe that if we can collaborate together, we can also to increase the economic scale of our customer. If you see on the 2020 this year, so we've got so many features that to be launched, like inquiry approval, financial forecasting, which is something like I believe to provide the data analytical to the customer. Someday it's quite difficult, for the customer to identify and to forecast on the financial aspect. So this will help the customer to forecast by data analytical. On the next slide, please. Yeah, this is just a sample that we are going to launch this year. This is something like not we are stopped here, Pak Natal, but we are going to launch a couple of the future this year. So basically, this is something like the to increase the and also to improve the customer experience by using the Kopra by Mandiri. It's basically just they can do just onboard the supplier by themselves without the human intervention, without any approval from the other part. Just click and put some details of the client and can send through us, and then we can proceed into onboard the supplier. On the next slide, so because we also have something like the Kopra apps, this is basically also we may integrate with the Logi in near future to support the customer or to provide the all customer to the transact through the Kopra manager as well as the Logi. On the next slide, please. On the next slide, okay. Previous slide, please. Yes, this is basically to give some of you the highlight. So basically, we have engaged with the Logi since last year. We've got a two page of the cooperation. First is basically like invoice financing. This is already done. And we can also to help the member of ecosystem by providing discounting financing of invoice. We can also provide with the competitive and attractive pricing. So basically, it was also to help the any kind of the member of the logistic ecosystem to get financing through Mandiri. I think that's all from me, Pak Natal dan Pak Kuncoro. Thank you so much for the time.
Yeah, thank you, Pak Norman, for the insight. So we learned then that the logistic ecosystem must actually engage many other capabilities, including cash management and financing. Big thanks, sir. Now we'll have Pak Gumilang as our next speaker. Pak Gumilang, I hear. Oh yeah, okay. We have seen Pak Gumilang, so cheerful and full of spirit. You can start your presentation now, Pak Gumilang. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Salam sejahtera. We are from the Aptirindo Association of Trucking Company. Our presentation today about the truck before pandemic and after pandemic. My slide is already sent to. Okay. The function of the truck is to serve the plant, to serve the industry, to serve the ship, and to serve the rail, and so many. So this truck is for the function is very important thing. This is we will explain the condition of the trucking before the business, before the pandemic. In that time, the industry was running normally and tending to develop. This is a positive effect of the logistic and transportation industry growing. This is has a positive impact. In the time market, it's already a very developed. Many new transport company have emerged. In the fact, there are around 1,900 company listed in Aptirindo, which the number of the truck up to 60,000 unit. The positive impact feel from the COVID-19 pandemic is in early 2020. Is market by industry throughout the Republic Indonesia treating work from home. Then automatically movement of good, both raw material and finished product is reduced. Export may be hampered and the number of employee already reduction. This has impact of decline of the number of mode transfer usage for the trucking mode drop up to 60%. This company cash flow was destroyed and many trucking industry were closed and effect of other industry on other industries. How to survive this condition? There are several this condition. The step taken by of the truck entrepreneur, which include first increase vehicle utilization by closely monitoring truck movement, making and adding truck stop area into pocket for collaboration for the truck entrepreneur in its sharing order by so on. The third is improve safety by increasing driver skill. Vehicle maintenance is better. Collaborating will have a strong bargaining power. And the fourth, sharing order of mode of transport. And the five, doing efficiency by process digitalization, vehicle utilization, incoming order and others. In the slide two, next. By using the digital, every mode of transportation, both land, sea, and air, can easily access and communicate with other. Not only one industrial zone, but also across region and zone, including overseas. The above also usually connect the use different mode of transport for one type of good. It can be land mode, then change to air or sea, and the end user receive good need receive it with another mode. So end to end can be easily run. Of course, everything will run by commitment and synchronicity. The utilization of the truck can be up by using digital digital program. So that's why we already work together with the telecom how to make a program for the truck efficiency. Thank you.
Thank you, Pak Gumilang. It's interesting, Pak Gumilang, so we can see what's the real experience in the field of operation that we need to put in our consideration when we designing the ecosystem. Many thanks, Pak Gumilang.
Thank
now,
you.
Yeah, thank you. It's an honor that our session today is also attended by Takao Omori, the President Director of NCT1.
Yep, my pleasure.
Yeah, after Takao-sensei, after the other speaker from digital and banking industry talk about the transformation, we are surely curious about what's in the mind of the expert of the logistic industry. So please, Takao-sensei, allow us to get your vision and feedback also in 15 minutes.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, Pak Control, for your introduction. And again, thank you very much for giving us this opportunity. Telecom Indonesia and Logi, my friend, Pak Natal, to share our experiences. So today, I'd like to introduce our initiative, how we are collaborating with digital platformers, especially Logi, to improve port-related productivity and our user customers' satisfaction. Next. Yep. I'm almost 37 years in logistics industry. And then logistics infrastructure, operating, developing, and design, and also supply chain optimization, especially automotive electronics. It's really supply chain sensitive. And also automation or robotics in apparel industry. We designed the really robotics or some automation for the Uniqlo distribution in Japan in terms of fulfillment and logistic design. Also digitalization. Now I'm really focusing on digitalization. It's gonna be the powerful tool to understand what's happening outside NPCT1 boundary, NPCT1 terminal, then using the data to improve customer satisfaction. I spent almost 3 years in this country working with the NPCT1 or platform players, Natal Logi team. But I got really excited to work with them in terms of in order to solve customer issues and problems. Digital initiatives in Indonesia is really agile and action oriented. Also make it happen, even comparing with other Asian countries, including Japan. Okay, so let's go to the next page. So quickly look at NPCT1 stakeholders. It's really unique. The Mitsuyan company, it's one of the largest Japanese trading houses who understand the import-export whole logistics supply chain, how to reduce the inventory to streamline the supply chain. Also PSA, the largest global terminal operator, and NYK, Japanese shipping line, and the Pelindo, the state-owned enterprise to operate majority of Indonesian ports. Next. Yeah, we are the most modern container terminal in Tanjung Priok with reliable equipment and 8 new, the largest key cranes and also yard cranes. Also the maximum depth of the draft to be able to accept the largest container vessels in Indonesia. Then next, some good really achievements as in PCT1, especially in terms of performance, productivity, and safety, and also importantly, internet security, having a internet security rating 800 or 900 from BitSight. Then look at the NPC1 in numbers. So thanks to the quick induration recovery after, not after, but the even 2020, the pandemic, then we are experiencing constant volume growth, and then vessel calls and DUs and trucks per day. Right now we are experiencing almost 3,000 trucks per day coming in and out from our terminal. But we are really keeping the good performance and the high level productivity. Dwell time, 2.5 days. When we designed this container terminal 7 years ago, dwell time was almost 7 to 10 days, but it's really dramatically improving the productivity here in terms of dwell days. Also, we keep the roughly 30 cycles in terms of key crane moves per hour, and that's gonna be the one of the best in Indonesia. And then 34 minutes turnaround time from gate in and out to really improve the productivity at our terminal. And what's happening not only in our terminal, but the most of the Asian terminals, vessel schedules are really fluky, not stable. And the future growth, is it limited to the yard space and physical constraints? And also looking at some terminals and the yard operation is triggered by truck arrival to the gate. And then as other body mentioned, looking at the our queue of trucks, I see many empty trucks, not only one way, but sometimes I see empty trucks in both ways, export, import. Why we see so many empty trucks? To find out solution, we need to review and take outside data beyond our physical terminal, especially cargo owner or terminal users processes and then tracking activities. So what we did, firstly, the step was to replacing our physical payment office with online processing. We had roughly over 700 daily visitors to our billing office. I mean, like, you know, banking counter. So we have decided to eliminate the physical process and then officially close our billing office last April before the second wave of the pandemic. So before our customers, terminal users has to come to our terminal, I mean, our payment office, that takes about 3 hours, 4 hours, depending on the customer or PBJK locations, it took almost 8 hours. But having this really paperless transaction, we call it eCon, Express Container Online in PCT1, we're able to make a transaction in minutes while avoiding physical contacts during pandemic. So this is a billing service anywhere, anytime, 24 hours access. Faster transaction without queue, cost and time efficiency, and cashless transactions, easy and safe. So right now, by collaborating with Mandiri and other banks, we are promoting auto collection features, a new and simpler option to settle transaction fast and secure through trusted banks, as an alternative to the current payment channel. And then those are really quite good features of Safety Pay, but most importantly, by having this kind of paperless transaction digitalize the process, NPCT1 is able to evaluate historical data when terminal user pay the fee and got the gate pass to get in and out from our terminal, and when trucks came into our facilities after those payment processes. So the second stage of digitalization, digital platform collaboration we call, in order to visualize our outside terminal activities, we needed this solid integration with our digital platformers by through exchanging data with our e-com. Next. You know, looking at the whole system, I mean, National Logistics Ecosystem, NLE, is somehow trying to link digitally whole holistic players from the export to import, outbound, inbound. But looking at the seaside, our clients' shipping lines is really internationally standardized, right? But looking at the land side, this I could say locally optimized, and not only locally optimized, but also as a Pak Natal mentioned, Pak Tarika mentioned, so many trucking companies you have to deal with. Daily 3,000 trucks, and then weekly and yearly. And then they have the really specific cargo and other requirement to meet the supply chain quickly. So I believe NPC Tibang or container terminals are well positioned to provide a reliable connectivity by linking seaside and land side, not only physically, I mean, not only just container handling, but also digitally exchanging the data. So looking at our seaside customers, we have international and domestic and regional content lines. But looking at the seaside, the, thanks to the existing digital players and so forth, and the next page, we are able to visualize the position data, yeah, next page, and able to exchange the EO data with our econ and having existing platform. But our challenge was really tracking platform, how we are able to get the data for the downside. Okay, so the next page. So we are right now working with the Logi and Telecom. For the land side, we're exchanging data with Logi and other platform players, providing one window to pay and then arrange tracks, dramatically improving customers' terminal related processes. And also in future, we are taking more initiatives to reduce empty chassis. Right now we have single tracks and then single export import. Why don't we make, let's say, dual cycle happen to exchange the data from single export players, single import players, by collaborating with Logi to improve the whole visibility and reducing the empty chassis. And also, thanks to it, we are able to reduce the CO2 consumption. Next page. So in order to improving our productivity, digital data beyond our physical boundary terminal is a key factor of success. For our equipment or human resource planning and dynamically positioning our resources. But again, more importantly, to provide the holistic digital platform linking seaside and landside through terminal operation at NPC T1 with the Logi, like a tracking platform, is really important. I think it's the ideal formation to energize Indonesian trade. I mean, the public-private partnership. Logi, Telekom Indonesia, Mandiri, Pelindo with NLE initiatives. Also private entities who understand the cargo owners' import-export needs. So I hope this real collaboration is started from terminal, but going to be regional and make it more national holistic logistics system, providing the more efficient operation to our cargoes in Indonesia. Yep. So lastly, for the next page, as NPCT1, we keep increasing export-import customers' competitiveness with a reliable performance, but really most importantly, promoting digitalization for seamless customer experience in supply chain, co-working with the reliable logistic platformers like Logi. So thank you very much. This is my presentation. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Taku Sensei. Arigatou gozaimasu. It's a very insightful for the audience here. Allow me to express great appreciation for all of us here. And after the session of Mr. Takao Omori, we are now having about half an hour to for the Q&A session. Regretfully, to avoid noise and others, the audience may only submit the question using the chat form. So please write your question. We are still waiting.
Hello, Pak.
I will read now the first question from Victoria Liu. Ms. Liu wants to ask Mr. Natal about the right approach in designing giant scale logistic platform, considering the currently siloed industry and the uniqueness of enterprises along the logistic supply chain operation. So that's the question for Pak Natal. How's your approach, Pak Natal, for this various efforts and unique enterprise during the value chain of logistics?
Thank you very much, sir. Victoria Liu, if I can choose, I will start by standardizing data interchange of the logistics. It is every industry, however different the supply chain and the company, it need to interchange information regarding logistics. Either it is invoice, proof of delivery, DO and SO. That is absent in Indonesia. If we see other country, even like Netherlands, they have a national logistic integration platform, NLIP. Singapore have Portnet. Malaysia has Dagangnet. South Korea has everything. China has no one, but China very big in Alibaba and so on. If I need to start in Indonesia, it will start with this standardization, EPI, EDI logistic, and providing a cloud. That's number two. So digital is very good place to start. And I hope that we together can support this, because logistic is unique, and no ministry of logistics. So in the other country, logistic player can arrange by themselves, make an organization and doing that kind of thing. So I will start with the data interchange. And number two, I will start with the Indonesia logistic cloud, where all logistic player can take their digitalization process easily and so on. So I think that's, and let me close this by, I have a good experience. I asking a multinational logistic company in Indonesia, I asking like this, why you don't you bother? Indonesia logistic is not efficient if you compare with your present in the other country. And he said, I don't care, Pak. Even Indonesia logistic not efficient, as long as my competitor in Indonesia also not efficient. you see the problem, correct? It is not problem for them, but it's problem for us, because as a country we are not going to be efficient. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Pak Natal. So that's our own
origin, Pak.
Yes, please. Who's that?
Okay.
I could not hear. Origin,
Pak. Origin. Yes.
Who is Mohan Isin? Yes. Pak Saleh.
Yeah.
Yes, please, Pak Saleh. But please in English, Pak Saleh.
Of course. Thank you, Pak, for the time and opportunity. First of all, I would like to congratulate to the Zoom meeting. This is the time we talk about the sector of the digitalization. I have one question regarding the, what do you call it, presentation from about the Logi mentioned before from Amin. A very short question about this one. If you are talking about digitalization of containerization of shipping industry to support the logistic industry in Asia, with this digital shipping movement, because if you are talking about cargo logistic, we cannot avoid. We have to involve. We have to engage with shipping industry, who will bring the containers into the to bring the container into the into loading into the ship, and how many shipping companies to participate and deal with this digitalization of logistics, because we are talking logistics at the end, the real doer for the logistic industry is the shipping industry, because shipping industry has all the facilities there. The ship is owned by the shipping company. The load cargo to be loading into the ship also has to be controlled and supervised by the shipping industry, shipping company. So how we manage all these things? How many companies participate for this logistic industry? Because you know that 20 Indonesia one of the largest, highest cost for logistics, logistic movement, more than 24% of national logistic cost higher than other countries, say Malaysia, Singapore. So that is my question regarding this logi. How is the involvement, participation of the shipping companies, shipping in that to participate in this system for digitalization of the logi in Indonesia. So thank you very much for the time. Can you hear me,
Pak? Yeah, sure. Only yes. A bit delay, Pak.
Let me introduce myself. Sure. I'm coming from the. I'm from the Consulate General of Indonesia in Dubai. Thank you.
Okay, yeah, thank you, Pak Saleh. So is it clear about the general strategy for Logi? But I will allow first Pak Saifu to answer, because this is I think this is quite a strategic question, Pak Saifu.
Yeah, of course. Thank you very much, Pak Saleh. Yeah. So maybe in short, what I can share as also what we has been done in Telkom, we try to start it from what we can do, and then we can start it from ourselves, and then we can start it now, because if not like that, just waiting each other, we think we have the ideal. I am really sorry about maybe the policy or situation. So just like mentioned by Pak Natal, yeah, the cost of our logistic will not going down. And then that's make very heavy in our national economics. That's why we are trying to help based on our expertise on digitalization, but we are really understood and we are really also realized that we are in Telkom cannot do it by ourselves. We need works together. That's why with the trucking association, with the port, with the banking and other parties on this ecosystem, including with the regulation and also with the academician. That's why we call it the ABCD and M with the media. We need to share and need to also always sounding that let's accelerate the digital ecosystem in Indonesia. It's like this theme of this webinar on workshop, because we need to realize our digital ecosystem sovereignty, because if not, we will afraid that we just becoming the consumer of this digital technology or digital ecosystem. That's why in conclusion, maybe Pak Soleh, let's together, we need to walk hand in hand, yeah, between the academician, within the business, within the government, within the media. Yeah, let's try and creating some successful use cases, because the successful use cases it become will be creating more confidence level, and then step by step we are adding and expanding the use cases. Maybe that's what we can say, and maybe that's I ask together that we can make that this the Indonesia digital ecosystem sovereignty, especially in logistic, it will happen shortly. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much, Pak Saiful. Excellent response, excellent reply. Congratulations, Pak Saiful, and the teams.
Pak yeah, thank you, Pak Saleh.
All the best, thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Pak Saleh. Now for the third question, I guess it's for Pak Norman. It's from yours truly, actually. It's about BUMN, Pak Norman, the state-owned company. The BUMN, the state-owned company, are rich in capabilities needed to develop logistic ecosystem. Besides banking, we have BUMN with business related to logistic, security certification, or energy distribution, and others. What do you think a good way to arrange multi-BUMN collaboration to speed up this establishment of the logistic ecosystem, Pak?
Yeah, good questions, Pak Kunchoro. So basically, what I'm trying to say is, when you go to the digital, we need some kind of the on the different angle to see what is the benefit for everybody on the ecosystem. That first thing first. As you know, that when we start to introduce our ecosystem solution, some of the challenges might happen from the member. First thing first is basically what is the cost incurred on the ecosystem, and then what is the value added that we can create when you go to digitalization. For example, the SLA in term of the, for example, the transaction, say H+3 working days, but nowadays if you can go to the digital, then it may reduce the working days up to H+1 days. It's something like that we need to consider. And the second thing, when we go to, you know, to implement on the ecosystem, we need some kind of, you know, the blessing from the regulator. That first thing first. Otherwise, that's what I see, Pak Njoro. Sometimes that we need some blessing from the regulator, you know, to go digital, and then everybody on the ecosystem will go and follow the guidance. Gitu, Pak. That's for example. And I believe, Pak, for the NPCT1, Omar Rizang, thank you so much for introducing Bank Mandiri and also cooperation with the NPCT1. But again, the challenges, it would come up in the near future, then I believe we can go with digital solution going forward. Thank you, Pak Kucoro.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Pak Norman. So while waiting for the written question, I have read also one question from the committee. Now it's for Pak Gumilang. Pak Gumilang. It's about multi-ecosystem now, that logistic ecosystem is actually not just like other ecosystem, like the ecosystem for agriculture or for small and medium enterprise, Pak Gumilang. Because we see that actually logistic ecosystem is the enabler to improve the other ecosystem. Without improvement in logistic, I think we can only offer very small value to agriculture or MSME, unless we can provide those ecosystem with better efficiency in logistic. What do you think, Pak Gumilang, about the integration of this logistic since the beginning, to maybe from agricultural, SME, or other that you can see related to our industry, Pak?
Thank you, Pak. Thank you, Pak Kancoro. I think I agree with you that all the sector will be must be integrated. Yeah. So integrated transport with Agrikarta is very, very, very important because output of Agrikarta is depend on the season and then not to be it cannot suspend because so as it's mungkin dalam bahasa Indonesia kalau ini kan sangat sensitif produk-produknya jadi tentunya harus tepat waktu. Saya kira masalah digital ini sangat sangat penting dan sangat tepat untuk digunakan juga ke sana. Gitu Pak Konsor. Makasih.
Ya, terima kasih. Thank you Pak Gemilang. So I think that maybe the question for the audience is not a real question, but only for a reminder, maybe Pak Gemilang, for all of us that when we design up this ecosystem, we should also look at the other ecosystem, what's there and how can we address. I don't know, maybe we need to ask the real question, those who question who show this question. Thank you, Pak Gemilang. So the audience, please, we are still waiting for more questions. We still have about 10 to 15 minutes for the more questions. Meanwhile, the committee also sent me another question now for Takao Sensei. Oh, okay. This is, I don't know. I hope I would not misread it. A bit funny. It's about 20 years ago, Elton John, Elton John, said that the internet actually only give very little value to a real human besides the information. What will make it valuable is actually when the logistic is transformed to make sure that real values, including product, goods, and even people, are transferred better using the internet. So for Takao Sensei, what's your vision of the future to see that logistics could really improve the way people will experience the internet and digital transformation in general?
Yep, very interesting question. thank you for sharing. But basically, in terms of logistics in Indonesia, everybody says the cost of logistics in Indonesia is really high, but it's not only direct cost, but especially inventory carrying cost due to the unreliability of the logistics. But the comparing with other Asian countries like Singapore, Malaysia, I believe Indonesian logistics is the mostly complicated. Even just looking at the Java Island, many entry ports and multiple demand area, and they have many options to really arrange the logistics. So to really find out the best answer and also to improve the productivity while eliminating the overlapping points, by especially exchanging data among the supply chain players. I mean, digital or internet gonna be really powerful tool, not only eliminating some kind of paper or processes, but to find out any points to improve the logistics cost related elements. So that is a power of digitalization. So I hope in future, the passengers on the planes or ferry, they complain each other if they see any issues. But maybe in future, even for logistics container or returnable boxes on trucks, having some tags or RFID, they're able to talk each other to find out the best solution to reduce the overall logistics. What I'm really expecting by utilizing the internet to let each cargo to discuss or talk each other digitally to find out the good solution. Thank you.
Thank you, Tantau Sensei. Okay, because we need to talk about the future to get our way in designing the ecosystem, I guess. Okay, I see that Pak Bambang Subekti has raised his hand. Pak Bambang, please please mention your name and institution and your question. Thank you.
Thank you, Pak. My name is Bambang Subekti.
Hello?
Yes, it's clear now.
Okay.
Okay, according to my question to Pak Natal.
Pak Natal, yes.
Yeah. I'm talking about the international topic. Okay. I didn't see the presentation from Pak Natal. The collaboration with the customer is very important.
Bambang, excuse me, I cannot hear you other than supply chain or and the name of Pak Natal.
Hello, Pak.
Yeah, it's no clear better? Now.
No yeah, better?
Much better.
Clear.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, my question is for Pak Natal. I'm talking about the international supply chain. Okay? Mm. One of the important role that we need to dealing with the custom as the regulator. Okay. So is there any plan from Logi to have the collaboration with the custom? Because I saw the presentation from Pak Natal so far just dealing with the business operator like terminal, trucking company, and etc. So I guess that we need to collaborate with the custom also. Also, it is related with the Pak Omorisan proposal, try to improve the productivity from the trucker, okay, and then to reduce the traffic jam in the road in Tanjung Priok area. That's the proposal is we call the dual cycle, meaning the trucking coming to the port, bring to the laden container for export, and then going back to load the import cargo. Okay? To make it happen, to have the dual cycle, meaning that the trucking company has to have the feasibility with the container export that already done for the custom clearance. So we call that the what we call the cargo or the hash, the SPPB, Surat Pemberitahuan Pengeluaran Barang. So whether Logi can help us to identify which the container import that already get the SPPB or the custom clearance done. That's my question, Pak. Thank you.
Okay, yes, thank you, Pak Bambang. Please, Pak Natal.
Thank you very much, Pak Bambang. Saya rasa, I think that working with the custom is mandatory, necessary, and we are keep trying, Pak. Actually, we are very happy when the concept of national logistic ecosystem emerging from the government. Yeah, I think it is quite fanfare, decree from the president and so on. And we are directly contact the NLE, and Logi is one of the first to asking them to do the integration, Pak. Because we believe that. But unfortunately, even NLA still need time to process because in my opinion, Pak, anyway, Pak, NLA is a government agency, not business agency. We need to take a little bit patient. But you are correct, Pak. I think we must contact and we keep contact. And now we even perhaps faster if we can get connected from the SPPB or custom through NPCT1 because you already got your TPS online. But we keep trying because we are government agency. Number two, it's very interesting how we are going to orchestrate it all. My point is, Pak, this COVID give us a very good important. Right now, everybody talking about satu data vaksin. Right now we need also satu data container, because we cannot do optimizing, balancing, and so on without identity of this all of this, yeah, container and truck and so on. Once we get this, feasibility will be happen, and when our feasibility will happen, I think that how we are going to connect internationally also be happen. But as I said, Pak, we have no Ministry of Logistics. Yeah. So I think, Pak, what we need is a pioneer, Pak.
So I think so.
I will always proud and thanks very much, Pak Omori. If I have question to Pak Omori, my question will be, what motivate you to open your platform? This will be my question. And Pak Gemilang, Pak Gemilang, I know years, Pak, and trust keep asking how to make it improve, because he said that truck is in the hilir, yeah, and I got all of the efficiency on me. We have no Ministry of Logistics, but we can be as a pioneer doing that. Mm-hmm. How about we do in NPCT1, Pak Omori and Pak Bekti? We do all balancing NPCT1 for 2,000 truck every day, Pak. 2,000 truck every day. And with Pak Gemilang, we can do that, Pak. Mm-hmm. I promise you with Pak Saipul, with Pak Saipul, that we can customize the platform, Pak. No worry. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Can one more question, Pak?
Is that Pak Babang or?
Yeah, still Pak Bambang. One more question.
Okay, sorry. Please, Pak Bambang. Okay.
Currently, you know, we are on the difficult for our exporter shipper is getting difficulty to get the containers because the shorted containers. Yeah? So, I challenge to Pak Natal again. Can Logi helping our exporter shipper to get the feasibility, how to find the containers? Meaning what? That you have to collaborate also with all international shipping companies. Now, around 20 shipping companies, what we call, operate in Indonesia. But now they only enjoy the pandemic era. Right? So got a very good revenue by the ocean freight. More than 300% or 500%. So how we can helping the out exporter and that improve helping the country to maintain the good, the what we call national balance state for the international sector related with the what we call disruption on the global supply chain.
Thank you, Pak Bedi. I ask Pak Omori and Pak Gemilang to add later on, okay? But this is very interesting question, Pak. Because I give you an example, Pak. Shipping, Pak Gemilang many times asking me how to extend the logi into the depot container. Because we all know that depot is belong to the shipping and all container must back to the same depot. It is also all crowded, okay? So, Pak Omori, it is not only truck that come one way empty, even the container also same, exported and all one way. But shipping is a king, we know that, you and I know that, and Pak Omori through Mitsui has very good relationship with the shipping, okay? Why don't we try with some depot that using the NPCT1, choosing one or two shipping, we do this container visibility and announcement. Yeah. They do not need, no matter, Pak. Telkom, Pak, telecommunication a long time ago, Pak, already understanding the situation. You can sending you message between operator, we don't care, Pak. If we have a tower, Pak, you can put your BTS there, we don't care, Pak. Right now, depo not like that, Pak. If I have depo in Tangerang, Pak, I must return to Tangerang. I cannot put it into the, so, again, we have no Ministry of Logistics. Ministry of Logistics is Pelindo, Pak Omori, Pak Gemilang, and Pak Saipul, I think, also Ministry of Logistics. So let's do this through pilot. Thank you very much. Please end, Pak Omori. Pak.
Yeah, thank you, Pak Natal.
Yes, Pak Omori.
And also, it's really interesting discussion. Yeah, firstly, my basic concept is a terminal should be really open to collaborate other players. Because firstly, container terminal, container loading or unloading is the trigger point for trading to trigger the payment process now, right? So because they, any C&A from the FOB, the title transfer should be at the port. So we have to really exchange the data when actually loaded, unloaded, and also linking the data with our stakeholders, I mean importers or exporters. That is really most important point for terminal or port should collaborate with multiple stakeholders. And also, I think digital collaboration beyond silo is really benefiting all players, because for NPCT1 terminal, by having a data when trucks are coming, when will be the peak, and when they pay the fee for terminal to get the cargo out or in, we are able to accumulate the tons of data to understand the pattern or cycle of each shipping company or its cargo owners. Terminals, we are not able to see the contents of the box, right? We are able to handle the boxes and improve the productivity, but not able to see what's inside. But by having a data, exchanging the platform like Logi, we're able to identify the customer location and trap cycle to improve our productivity, how to position our resources, human resources or equipment, but also able to share the data to those truck platformers with other trucks to make a dual cycle happen, for example, as backup might mention. Mm-hmm. I think this open collaboration, I mean, digitalization, is quite natural for terminal to collaborate with those players to really create the win-win situation. But I believe, especially in Indonesia, it's really energetic, the digital initiatives, and then really the policymaker-driven logistics improvements. I believe it's going to happen. Yeah, let's make it happen.
Thank you, Marisan. Pak Gulan, have something to add?
Yeah. I think... the shipping company should be working together with us to make the depot more efficient. As we know that the container is part of the shipping, part of the shipping company. So that's, if you working together with the depot cannot serve the data, all the data. But as you know that the initially that the container is stored in the new harbor, now already moved to the other side. So that means we cannot control all of the container. In my experience, that the container takes container, one container more than 2 hours or maybe 4 hours. So this means tracking productivity already dropped because we waiting the container ready to bring to the customer. So that means it's the important cause we work with the shipping company to make it more easily. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Pak Gumilang. Audience, I'm sorry to announce you that the time is almost running up now. Now I'd like to ask a speaker for a closing statement. What we have learned today, what we will do, or what collaboration will be arranged, or we will make anything. Maybe only one or two statements for each speaker, starting from Pak Saiful, please.
Maybe just one word. Let's make it happen.
Wow. Let's make it happen. Wow.
Or adding, let's make happen now. Starting from now. Thank you.
Thank you, Pak Saiful. Now, Pak Natal, please.
Yeah, this logistic need pioneer, and we are all pioneer. And this is our time. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Pak Natal. Now, please, Pak Norman.
Yeah, I think from the from myself, I see from the banking perspective that one more thing that I would like to highlight that again, even though that we did come up with digital, we still need bank. So let's open together to open banking with us, and then we can try to customize the all the digital solution for the logistic ecosystem. Thank you, Pak Kunjaro.
Yeah, thank you, Pak Norman. Halo, Pak Gumilang.
Digital can be more efficient for logistics, I think. Also.
Great, I believe that too. Thank you, Pak Gumilang. Yes, now please start.
Yep, I agree, Pak. Let's make it happen. Digital multiplied by logistics, or logistics multiplied by digital. Make it happen, starting from this great partnership. It's really exciting.
Excuse okay, me. Thank you.
Can I take the time, the floor, please? Pak Kunjoro?
Who's that?
Can I take a moment, please?
But I think the time is running out.
Yes, just a few seconds.
Okay, please.
Yeah. Thank you, Pak Kunjoro, moderator. It's a great pleasure for me to participate for this event. As you know that we together with Pak Saiful, we are now in Dubai. We are hoping that we will penetrate the Dubai market and the United Arab Emirates. That you know, as you may know, that in Dubai, most of people are speaking English. So for me, English is my second language. My third language is Spanish, and the fourth language is Arabic. So I can speak four languages. So you don't worry talking about English, Pak Kunjoro. And then. Talking about this opportunity in Dubai, that come and visit to Dubai because Dubai is more advanced in logistic industry. So this is one of the top country in terms of logistic and transportation. So let you know, if talking about logistic, come and visit to Dubai. So let us know how big the development and the advancements of Dubai in the logistic and transportation industry. So it will be fine if you come visit to Dubai. To all speakers, experts, let's come visit to Dubai together with Pak Saiful. So I think we'll be happy to facilitate and come see directly the Dubai and surrounding United Arab Emirates. Thanks a lot, Pak Saiful, Pak Kunjoro. Thank you for them. Congratulations. All the best for the successful of the event. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Pak Saleh. Muchas gracias. I need to learn Spanish now. Okay, so I'm sorry to announce you that the time is up now. We have to close this igniting session. Yeah, like you, I'd also like to hear more about our excellent speaker, but I guess this is only a beginning of our long-lasting networking and collaboration, so never worry. And I would like again to express my or our deepest gratitude to the speakers, but also to all the participants, for our active participants and the committee who has made this session a successful and fruitful event. Now, let me return this to our MC to close the session. Many thanks.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kunjoro, our moderator today. Such interesting and enlightful discussion. And also would like to thank you for the all honorable speakers. Thank you for sharing with us your knowledge, your expertise, and your experience. And also for the all participants for today's discussion. Ladies and gentlemen, big applause for our moderator and our great speakers today.
Thank you.
We are live from Expo 2020 Dubai at Indonesia Pavilion, and this business talk presented by Telkom Indonesia in collaboration with Ministry of State on Enterprise. And at 13:30 Dubai time or at 16:30 Indonesia time, we will have another business talk held by Telkom Indonesia with topic the digital era of agriculture and fisheries, connecting the unconnected. This is the end of business talks. Thank you to the audience that have participated actively. Thank you once again for all honorable speakers, moderators, and all distinguished guests. On behalf of all Telkom Indonesia, we would like to thank you for your participation. We still have business talk from the 23rd and 24th March 2022, live from Expo 2020 Dubai at Pavilion Indonesia. For more details, please check the Indonesia Pavilion website, expo2020indonesia.id, and Telkom Indonesia Instagram at Telkom Indonesia. My name is Ira Juhri Menecini. Thank you very much. Keep following the COVID-19 protocol. Stay safe, stay healthy, and catch me later. Goodbye for now. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Yep, thank you.
Waalaikumsalam.
Ya. Thank you so much, Pak.
Pak Kunchoro, Pak Natal.
Terima kasih. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Om Horisang, Pak Kunchoro, Pak Bambang,
Pak Natal. Thank you.